Hello everybody, Sift here again, and today I'll be playing Bio Prototype. Now the game is a, roguelike survival bullet heaven hell game, whatever you want to call it, and the uniqueness is that you can create broken builds. Like, this is supposedly one of the most broken build generating games. Let's get into it. Prototype with nothing special. This is the first character we have. Now today my voice is going to be a bit different because I'm sick, but we have to do our job, you know. So let's get to it. Survive 15 waves of enemies and easy research prototype testing. Even rookies can handle this research. Let's do it. And this is our starting prototype. And this is my starting weapon, which is, I guess, just a little machine gunnery. Now the uniqueness of this game, by the way, first of all, let's explain some basic things. We gather these resources here called cells. You can see the number over here, and then this down below that is the classic, I guess not the classic, but I would say that that's from Rotato, where you just amass the secondary resource. You're gonna see in a moment. Limb of the Germ Rat. Launch a short range attack in a circle in front of you when activated. 13 damage, 14% crit chance. Spine of the Mammoth, activate the right side organ periodically, and then Spine of the Mammoth again, activate the right side organ periodically every 0.3 times per second or 0.39 times per second. So what is this? What am I seeing here? Well, to be honest, these here are activators, and this is a spell, I guess, an attack. Let's first of all pick up an attack, and I'm going to explain in a moment what we're going to be seeing here. This is a tentacle that says fires a spinning projectile activated. Projectile when it's activated, doing 11 damage with 6-second cooldown. Limb of the Germ Rat again, but this time it doesn't have this thing here, the vessel amount thing that it previously had. And Tentacle of the Hornet, pressure projectile when activated. Once again, not with this thing. Let's take this for a moment. Let's take the vessel, and let's go into the mutation, and now I will begin to explain things. So over here is the brain, and, left of the brain is... this is my skill tree. This is all my abilities that we're going to be using. Right? So right now I only have a Spine of the White Fox, activate the right side of the foreground periodically every 1 second, and it shoots this thing, the Tentacle of the Pupa, fires a projectile when activated. And right now I'm missing an organ, so let's just go into another one real quick, and I'm gonna explain after that when I will get an organ that's actually gonna help us. Now previously I tried to explain what this is. This is like Rotato, for which means that any XP that I didn't pick up previously, or I guess any money or resource or currency or whatever you want to call this, the cells, you know, every cell I didn't pick up previously now will give me double cells for this round. So that's literally the Rotato system with not picking up currency. That's pretty much it. Now the currency itself is used for upgrading my character, because that's also a thing in this game. I didn't go into it because we were a bit too poor, but we're gonna go into it in a moment. We found a Tentacle of the Starfish, fires multiple projectiles in a circle when activated, 12 damage, 17 crit chance, fires a projectile repeated when activated, and then Vessel, Spine of the Jackal, Vessel Amount 2, this is important, activate the right side organ periodically once every 1.29, actually 1.29 times per second, which is faster than the one we have. But the efficiency is 87%. We're gonna take this to start explaining things. We found our spine here and a limb. Launch a short range attack to rectangle in front of you when activated. Once again, coral fires projectiles repeatedly when activated. I do enjoy this. And then activate the right side organ periodically. Let's go for the coral for a moment. Let's go into mutations. And here I'm gonna now explain. So we're gonna take this. As you see, Spine of the Jackal. We can put this in. And now this is gonna activate once every 29 seconds. After the Tentacle for the Pooper fires these two skills. Or we can do the opposite. We can put this here. So we have this line. And I can also create a secondary line. So first of all, I can, for example, say, okay, I want you. You know, I want to fire a Tentacle of the Pooper and also fire one of these. I don't have anything to put here, you know, as a spine. But I could put here, for example, this. Now let's go really quickly into testing and see what this looks like. So as you can see, first of all, we have the explosion around us, which is this part here, right? The germ of a rat or whatever. And then if you see my bullet, at the very end of the path of the bullet, you can also see, you know, once in a while, a bullet appears. Whoa, I got hit on training. Okay, that's cool. But yeah, as you see, we have this spinning thing happening. Now, theoretically, right, I could do this. And now it's going to be the opposite. That's going to look like that. They go around us, and then once in a while, they shoot too. Which looks, in my opinion, a lot better. Like, this looks like a lot better and also a lot more DPS-wise. Or I could do this, right? Now it's gonna look like that. It's still gonna be spinning, but now every time the spin goes off, it shoots like a couple of mini projectiles. Once again, we can switch and swap here and all the time remake the build just to see what it looks like. Now you can see it's like some machine gunnery that projectile bounces. But honestly, I'm gonna say, let's go with the... let's go like this. This spins, and then this does 3 damage, this does 8, so let's go like that, and I think we're good here. So that means that we're going to be shooting the circles, and then these circles are going to be shooting as if they are also... Like, this reminds me of Gungeon. Once again, I could also, like, swap these, and now when these circles go around, it's going to explode, right? Yeah, you see, now we're doing explosions whenever those things go around, which actually seems a lot more awesome. And then we also have, like, a little machine gun on the side, which now I can switch with this, for example. And that's going to be, once again, a little machine gunnery that bounces around, which I think looks even better. So let's go with this build. And Krolcher, as you see, is a shop, so we can go more HP, more movement speed, more anything that we want. We're going to keep these to try to get organ quality or drop rate. So let's go into the fight now. I'm sorry for this taking a while, but I tried to explain the basics of the game. And yeah, now that we got the basics down, I think you will understand that we can create some very, very broken stuff here. So that is the plan for today, of course, to create broken stuff and just chain react a bunch of things into each other. So we just destroy the universe or the PC. I mean, I don't think this game is going to destroy the PC. This isn't Souls and Survivors, but still. Let's continue going around picking up resources. I think we already got a pretty decent-ish build going on here. I like that we also change what we look like based on what we have on us. Like, we have the coral on our head and we are keeping the mushroom in our hand too. So it's always awesome. And here we got some things. So whenever you see double on the right side, I think it's a good one. Activate the right side organ while the left side organ hits any target. Ooh, this sounds extremely powerful. Everything that hits, wow, this sounds actually insane. Atomizes the effect of the right side organ and makes it surround. I don't know what this means, but might be good. Spread effects of the right side organ on ground. Okay, we're gonna go with Nerve of the Boxer. Like, whenever the left side hits something, the right sides activate. Lung of the Puffer. Atomize the effect of the right side organ makes it strong. Yeah, we read that. Activate the right side organ while the left side organ hits the target. That's also good. And then fires a projectile repeatedly when activated. I want this again. I want the... Yeah, I definitely want this again. Whoa, I hit something here next to me. I'm sure for that. So let's go on. Spine. Activate right side organ periodically. This is the most boring one. Tentacle. Fire multiple projectiles in a circle when activated. Sounds good. 11 damage. Also good. And then Limb of the German Rod. Once again, launches short range attack in a circle in front of you when activated. This is the explosion thing. I'm going to say let's get this. Let's get Tentacle of the Starfish. Let's go into mutation. And we got the machine gun here. So a really, really good idea, of course, would be to put this in. You know, activate the left, the right side organ while left side organ hits any target, of course. By the way, as you can see, these two are different. This is a rare one, which gives me 2 slots and 47% efficiency, while this gives me 1 slot and 31% efficiency. And also, you can recycle and throw them away if you want, but we're not going to do that right now. As of weapons, I guess we're going to go with the machine, the normal shot. And then we're also going to go with Starfish. And let's see how this is going to look, right? Okay, madness has begun. But the thing is, why stop there? Why not go with explosions here and machine gunnery over there, right? Testing. Let's see what the explosion machine gunnery looks like. Ooh, yeah, this looks even better in my opinion, right? The circles are doing their machine gunnery. And then the last but not least, I guess we could try this, which I don't think would make any sense in being better, but you never know, right, man? You never know. No. We're going to go with the machine gunnery is with the circling around and then explosions and starfish with the machine gun that we have. So this goes around and shoots out bullets as if it's like a machine gun, I guess a gun that swirls and also attacks. And then we also got the machine gun that explodes and also shoot out all these starfish. So let's go into culture. The first plan is to go with organ quality and quantity, I would say. But honestly, I think your brain is able to control 2 additional organs per level. I think this is a play. By the way, you can also get a second brain, which is also very powerful, because you can literally have like a second brain that you just put skills in, which right now we don't need. So let's go into culture, let's go organ quality so we find better stuff, and I would say let's go. I think movement speed is good. 15% increase movement speed. Yeah, we're gonna go 15%. 15 sounds good. And explosions, very nice. And as you see, look at this, we're gaining 2 at a time, right? We're getting 2, I guess, cells at a time, as that is literally what we got. Yep, what is this? Is this an elite? I guess we're finding an elite. Elite's toast. I don't know what the elite gave us. Also, there are levels down here in the bottom right left corner. I'm not exactly sure what the levels provide you. I would assume they provide you with some kind of, you know, rare organ when you level up or something. I don't know. I'm destroying everything as always, as we are very powerful already. And another elite. Nice. Give me as many elites as possible, as my build seems to be good against them. Or at least right now, right? Because we don't know how good or not we are going to be later in the run. And of course, as long as I'm getting cells here, I will be able to level up the damage done, the crits. Like, you can get a bunch of things. Oh, this is what we got. Nice. So I got Tentacle of the Beetle. Fire whirly projectiles when activated. Okay, I'm gonna take that. Retina, okay, an eye. Retina of the Raven. Activate the right side organ while hosts affected by the left side organ die. Okay, hosts. I would assume that's for a debuff, right? Like I have some kind of debuff, and then when the debuff expires or when the unit that has the debuff dies, then with 400% efficiency, that thing activates. This sounds good. This sounds actually good. Spine of the Jackal once again activates right side, theoretically, not really. And then we also got the Tentacle of Starfish, which is even more explosions, 11 there. You know what? Let's take this actually. Wings of the Gargoyle. First of all, this is blue. Atomize the effect of the right side organ and makes it surround. Rate 0.1 times per second. That sounds really bad, right? That's like almost never. Clear off the cat. Activate the right side organ while effects of the left side organ expire. Okay, this is also for debuffs, I guess. And then grants chance to avoid damage taken for a duration when activated. The buff effect scales with efficiency of the left side organ. I don't really care about this. Let's go with... I guess let's go with this just because it's rare and I want to understand what this is. It's commutation. Let's see, can I put it anywhere? I guess I can only put it here. Which, what will that give me access to? Nothing. I cannot put anything on the right side of this because I don't have wings, belly, or poison bag. Nice. Atomizes the effect of the right side organ and makes it surround. Yeah, whatever that means. Whatever that means. Anyway, let's go on with activates right side organ when the left side hits in target. Yeah, against the periodically. Periodically is just bad. And then over here, I would say boomerangs. Then we also beetles. Let's try to see what the boomerangs would look like. Because maybe it's going to be awesome. Oh, yeah. This looks a bit better. Oh, yeah. Look at this madness. Yo. That's how we're going to go with. With that, let's go with organ quality once again. Seems like the scaling, there is no scaling, just straight up. Let's go crit chance, why not? And let's run into this. Yeah, seems like upgrading things. Wait a minute. Did the crit chance go up though? I think the crit chance did go up. The cost at least. I should really, really invest the cells into getting stats, because that's how we're gonna scale, right? By definitely investing those in, because as you understand, the organs seem to have like some base amounts and base stats. What is this? I think I just found an organ again. That seems to be a nerf, so it is most likely going to be, you know, another nerf. Very nice. Another one. Wow. I upgraded quality, not quantity. I don't know what's happening, but it is what it is. The one I'm not exactly sure of is this. Can I see from 220? Boom, 250. Okay, that means 3D coins. That's what that means. Now we know. Let's avoid those. I think movement speed is very important here. And also max life, maybe, in case I make a mistake. Who knows how many organs we got here. We're really quickly expanding in power level. We're power creeping through this extremely fast. I already got 300 coins for the next level up. And another one, 360. Very nice. And look at all that, what we got. We had that. The germ rat, we know what this is, the explosion. Activate the right side organ while the left side organ hits anything. Very nice. Efficient 25 though is bad, but whatever. Same thing, but with 54. Very nice. Belly of the Blood Coral. Inflict trauma on the target for a duration when activated. Trauma can be stacked multiple times. Through each stack has its own duration. Okay, so because each stack has its own duration, we can definitely get that thing that says when a duration effect expires. Although, yeah, this also has a right side. So, trauma deals damage to the target each time it targets a new trauma stack. This damage is based on stacks of trauma the target already has. Okay, so it's a debuff that does more damage based on how many debuffs there are already. So, if, for example, they have 10 stacks of trauma, then an 11 stack is going to do 11 damage. That's how I understand this. Of course, it says damage 3 here, so I don't even know what it means. Lung of the Knoll. Atomize the effect of the right side. Yeah, we know what that is. And then activate the right side periodically, which is... Who cares? Retina of the Raven. This is a rare. Activate the right side organ while host effect by the right side organ die. Efficiency 521. I'm gonna take this. Just because it's legendary. Fire... Whoa. This is double low. Fire self-surrounding projectile when activated. This might be better. Because if this says that... yeah, if I activate this... I'm 50-50 on these. You know what? Let's see. Right side combat ability has to be a tentacle limb or offspring. And this itself is a retina. Can I actually use this? Oh, nice. I am allowed to see. So, do I have anything that allows a retina? This doesn't say anything about retina. Nor that, nor this, nor that. So, I can definitely not use retina right now at all. So, there is no reason for me to take this. That's because it's a retina and it has no combat ability with anything. We're going to go with this, though. Killing of the Dragon Heart. Belly. Inflict blaze on the target for a duration. When activated, blaze can be stacked multiple times. Through each stack has its own duration. When the duration is blazed ends, a unit affected by blaze dies. All blaze stacks are consumed instantly, triggering an explosion. Explosion damage and radius are based on stack consumed. Okay. but it has no right side, so that's an ending. Activate the right side organ when damage taken. Who cares? And then activate the right side organ periodically, rate 1.29 per second, and it has a double right side, so I would say let's get this. Intestine. Spread effects of the right side organ on the ground. I mean, you know what? It's compatible with the belly, which was the fire thing, so I guess this could spread the fire on the ground. Activate the right side organ periodically, and activate the right side organ periodically. This is a slow one, this with good efficiency. This is, let's just get intestine, just so we have something. And I would say let's create a second brain. So let's create a second brain. Very nice. Let's go with mutation. Now I got a second brain here that I can play with. Do I want to upgrade the first brain, though, is my first question. So, belly of the blood coral. I could theoretically just put that in there. You know what? Let's actually start creating a second brain. There is no reason to force ourselves. So first of all, we're going to get the white side activates periodically. So we got, you know, something going. After that, I'm going to say let's go with this, which is the surrounding thingy. After that, let's get when the left side hits, right? Yeah, but if it hits any target, and the other one would be optimize the effect of the right side organ to make it surround. Let's try that. This is the only thing that can actually combo with that. And when this hits something, I guess explosions. And when the explosions hit something, I guess starfish. Actually, why would I do that? I guess starfish, the opposite. Let's go starfish, and then when the starfish hits something, explosions. That sounds good to me. And then we're out of brain capacity again. Now, both of these brains happen at the same time, as far as I know. So now we have pretty much everything. We have both of these brains working. As you see, this is Madness Incarnate already. I don't need to go further into this. Let's continue with the quality. As we have definitely become more powerful than the previous version of this. So we don't really need to invest into anything here. That would be DPS-wise. I think my voice is becoming deeper and deeper because of the sickness. So, by the way, bioprototype. We are creating like a super virus here or whatever, and I'm sick. Very fitting, I would say, that I start this game while being like that. Now, I'm gonna pause the video in a moment here because I need to, you know, do the classic case of take medication, etc., etc., to fix myself a little bit. Anyway, let's continue on. 40 seconds for the wave, by the way. Seems like the waves are becoming bigger and bigger, which is actually really good. As bigger waves means we gain more money, and more money we gain means we do more damage, right? We're gonna power up ourselves by increasing the quality of things we find, or by just straight up increasing the damage we do, because why not? I think I should invest a couple of my cells here into definitely increasing my damage and whatnot. Although, to be honest, the madness is already too much. Oh, I just realized we have those thingies flying around us, and if they don't hit anything, I guess the explosion thing doesn't happen. Well, if that's the case, then I don't really want this. I don't want the dragon thing here to be the one that goes in loops. The retina again. Heart of the wolf. Activate the right side organ when damage taken. I don't want this. Activate the right side organ periodically. Once again, I don't want any of these. Activate the right side organ when it has to affect. You know what? Let's just take the retina. Nerve. Blue one. Activate the right side organ while the left side organ deals crits. Okay. Spread the effect of the right side organ. Let's take the on crits. Activate the right side organ after 4 seconds without damage taken. What? Why would I take this? Let's take this. Poison bag of the wyvern. Deals damage over time to the target when activated. Okay, this is a poison bag. We got our first poison bag. And it's also blue, so let's just straight up take it. You know what? Let's go culture and let's get another brain. No, I don't have enough money. Well, it is what it is. It is what it is. Base damage up. 10% increased damage. Well, let's mutate. Go to our second brain. Honestly, I don't enjoy this that much. But I can't really put anything in there. Where could I put this? I guess in the atomized thing. You know what? Instead of doing that, let's have this as it is. And let's try to see if I can fit that thing in here anywhere. I could put it in the machine gunnery instead of the stars or instead of the explosions. Or actually, I can have it on that. Let's see what this looks like. So let's go testing. So my machine gunnery now poisons opponents. That's what it does. I see everything is poisoned. Every single thing on the map is poisoned right now. So nice. I enjoy that. I enjoy poisoning opponents. I would say, maybe instead of starting with this, I should start with a boomerang, right? And then the boomerang on hit, yeah, on crits. What's the crit chance of this? 15%? No. What is this? Excuse me, what's that? I don't even know what I'm looking at. And I don't even know what these do. What am I watching at? I don't even know what I'm watching here. Did I combine some things? I have no idea what I did. Well, not on crits. These are still the same. On hit. Let's go on hit. On hit, I would say now I can invest into the loops. right? We boomerang, so after the boomerang hits, the loops are gonna happen, or the machine gunnery is gonna happen. So everything spreads. And then that thing on hit, do I have another on hit? Yeah, on hit. If that hits, then we do this. And then after that, I guess we're gonna go with atomize the right side effect. And the right side effect is going to be this. Can I see this in action? And I have some boomerangs that when they hit the machine gun, and then those, wow, look at around us. Just look at what's happening around us. Oh yeah, madness incarnate. Nice, love it. Off we go. Culture, let's continue with quality. And let's also get 1 HP just in case. And you know what? Give me a pause here. I'm gonna give me a pause. Okay, I'm back. I don't think my voice is fixed in any way, shape, or form, but let's just hope for the best. So now the plan is to just create an infinite amount of spikes around us. As you can see, we have some spikes around us just floating all over space. Now, theoretically, we're also poisoning opponents. So that's also something that could maybe help us. I'm seeing that opponents are going faster and faster, by the way. Look at all the spikes. Look at all the spikes around us. The madness. I think this is definitely a better layout than the previous one we had, where the things around us were triggering the spikes. Yeah, I think it's better like this. And I think we're going to go for another brain right now, so I can set up another crazy mad lad combination. And then we're going to start selling things. I think I want to start selling some things. I don't need every single organ that we have. We should definitely reinvest organs into money, and money into brain power and brains in general, you know, just so we have more, etc, etc. Of course, to get another brain, to get brain power, actually, not our brain, to get brain power is 1,000 resources, which it makes sense, because getting brain power is what allows you to create those chain reaction effects, right? With only 8 brain power, you can only get so many things to chain into each other. Well, if you have like 10 or 12 or something, you can definitely get a lot more things going. There are also characters in this game that you can unlock. It isn't only about this one guy here with no passive, no ability. Retrieve unpicked organs, 70%. What? Oh, there were organs on the ground that I missed. Okay, I see. Tentacle. Once again, but with a double right side. I enjoy that a lot. Also 12 damage and 27% crit chance. Activate the right side organ periodically. Decrease the target range. No, we're going to go with this. Let's go tentacle. Tentacle of the mushroom. Another 2 sides. For projectiles that trace targets automatically when activated. 15 damage, 30% crit chance. That's really good. Poison bag of the wyvern. 3 points. Deals damage 7 when activated. And wow, 10 damage. Duration 3 seconds. Max stacks 1. Max stacks 1? What? You know what? I want to take this. Although this has a triple right side, I want to take this. Let's go with culture. I'm going to say let's go in our brain for 400. So we get even more combos going. Let's go into the third brain and let's start creating something here. So atomize the right side of fire when it's around. Activate the right side organ periodically. We always begin with an activate the right side organ periodically once per second. And now we're going to start the madness. Let's go with this. First, we just got the target automatically. And we're going to go with this. On crits, this has a 3% crit chance, so on crits is gonna definitely be happening. Okay, here we can go with a starfish. And we can also go with a normal machine. Yeah, because this side, I can't really get anything out of that. You know what, let's actually get an explosion on this. So whenever this thing crits, it's gonna shoot out starfish and also explosions. And then the last but not least, I guess, once in a while, not enough duration. I don't know what that means. Well, regardless, this here, I really don't know what not enough duration means. And let's actually begin. Maybe I could actually have this here. Not enough duration. Yeah, I don't know what not enough duration means. And I can't really see anyway. Can I use this anywhere? Spread effects of the right side organ on the ground. I don't think I can have this anywhere. This is an intestine, and only things that chain into intestines can possibly use that. So most of these cannot, if not any of these cannot. The retina is literally not fitting anywhere. Yeah, you can see where things can fit while highlighting them. As you see, I could have it here, like this. Rate 0.3 and 3%. So if I do this. What? Missing tip. I don't understand what this is supposed to be. I guess this was what I previously had. That's the only explanation right now. So if I take this away, for example, which I can't really... Can I now put this in back in? Yeah. I have no idea. Anyway, let's rebuild what I just destroyed. So let's actually put this here. Actually, you know what? Let's put this here. And now I can have this. Theoretically, Now we can do this. This should not say not alteration. Yeah, now it doesn't say not alteration. We're gonna go on crits explode and on crits starfish. And then we're gonna go on every once in a while also shoot out, I guess. These three don't really fit anywhere in the whole build. Oh, wait a minute. Nope, they actually don't fit anywhere in the whole build. Oh, I can put the retina over here. Nice. I found where the retina fits. Damage over time, and then what does the retina do? Activate the right side organ while host affected and the left side organ die. Aha, so when I poison something, it activates whatever is on the right side of this. Okay, I see. And let's maybe sell this thing. Maybe let's not sell anything. Let's actually go. I think the test is irrelevant here. Yeah, we definitely do a lot of things. And off into the fight. Off into the fight. So for the best... DPS-wise, we're doing some 3D damage hits. Which is, of course, on the higher end of things. Okay, opponents are starting to move a bit faster. Which is a concerning fact, but also not really that important. I see the things that are doing loops around us. These yellow things seem to be the new thing. They're supposedly doing explosions and whatnot on crit. Explosions and starfish hits on crit. Whoa, avoid everything that we can. I think the best one is the one that says on hit trigger. But the thing is that on hit triggers reduce the, efficiency of the right side weapons. If you see, all of these organs have efficiency ratings. And the things that say on hit activate. Oh, I got hit. Yes, it seems like these opponents that are pretty fast-ish are an issue. I should go into big circles around, trying to maybe find some kind of organ that dropped, although I'm not really seeing it. Theoretically, we should only be finding legendary organs in a moment. And also, theoretically, I should be rotating back into my first brain and try to maybe add those high-tiered weapons we are finding now. So we, start becoming more powerful and do more damage and also have more chain reactions into each other. Although I have to say, the very first thing we created actually became busted very quickly. The machine gun into explosions into starfish spikes. Tentacle of the Hornet. Fires projectiles when activated. And that's it. 20 damage, 33% crit chance. Doesn't have right side, doesn't have anything. Let's take it. It's legendary. Cochlea of the Cat. Activate the right side organ when effects of the left side organ expire. This is about poison. Sorry, let's take this. It's a cochlea. Wings, Ring of the Fairy, grant increased organ activation rate for duration when activated. The buff effect scales with efficiency of the right side organ. Let's go with this, machine gunnery. Let's go mutation. Can I put this anywhere? Fires a projectile when activated. Let's do it here. Maybe that's good. Can I put this anywhere? I don't think I can. I don't see anywhere where that could fit. Yeah, I don't have any anything that accepts that. Is there anything here that I could fit? I don't think I could. Poison on the stars, explosions. I think we're good. What is this? Yeah, the damage thing. I could do that with poison. Or I could do that with this. Right, let's try this here. So when all of these hit, I gain attack speed. Let's try this for a moment. Does the attack speed happen, or... I think it happens. Okay, DPS-wise, this looks crazy. I'm doing some 40 damage hits there. I enjoy this. Let's go culture. Another brain. Not really. I think I want brain capacity. Or just go with damage, I guess. Let's go with damage. Let's go with crit chance, actually. Crit chance, let's go with crit chance, even more crit chance, as we do have some organs that are like crits on crit activate. So I think this is the play. Bye bye every one of you. Doesn't matter if you have a lot of life or not, we're chain reacting a million things into each other, so you won't be doing anything. Oh man, the coughs are pretty much bad for you guys, I'm pretty sure. But I can't do anything about it. Maybe drink some water. Maybe pause the video. Oh, look, another elite. Okay, we're waiting for the elites. Two elites. Time to pick up a bunch of organs. Let's go. I think I should just straight up just throw away all the eyes I have. Because I don't see the eyes being useful anytime soon. The corneas or whatever. Come on, elite. Go down. Thank you. A spine. That was the yellow spine. I'm finding yellow spines, yellow eyes, a bunch of yellow things. Which is really good. Yellow is rare. I'm not sure if there are red things, being a legendary or something. But we definitely are finding a bunch of things here. Which is, of course, really, really good. Let's continue going around trying to pick up all those materials up. Another drop. Very nice. Theoretically, I could also invest even more money. Theoretically, I could also invest into drop chance on these, on organs, organ drop chance. I mean, if I think about it, organ drop chance is money, as if I get like so many organs that I don't know what to do with them, I can start selling them. Therefore, they give us money back. And that happens very quickly, theoretically speaking, right? The moment you pick up like three organs from organ drops. Oh, come on. Time run out. Look at this. Written of the Raven. Legendary. And also Spine of the Fox. Legendary. Activate periodically. 152. Cockley of the Cat once again. 30 damage, 40 crit chance. Oh, yeah. Is this fire worldly projectiles when activated? Yeah, that's the boomerang thing. 8 damage. Space. Intestine of the Slime. Nerve of the Boxer. Yeah. On hit, activate. We take that instantly. Turning off the beat. That's a boomerang again. With double right side. I'm gonna take it. I've got Lung of the Gnarl. Atomize the effect of the right side. Well, I think this is trash, by the way. I think it's really mediocre. Let's take it to sell it, mostly. So, yeah, let's sell the atomization effect. Delete. 50 coins right there. Activate the right side. Once again, this is a level 7. Let's go here. We already have this. We already have the activate thing, but look at this. 31 compatibility. 57. So, efficiency. So, here you go. This is double activate or activate. I enjoy these. You know what? Activate on activate is really good on hits. Once again, on hit. Let's go with the on crit. Yeah, this here is on crit with crazy efficiency. But we're gonna go here. Then we're gonna go with what can be put in there. I guess this right side of the limb. What could I put here though? On crit. How much crit chance does it have? 35%. What could I put there that has higher crit chance? 37, 32, 30, 40. Let's put this here. This is periodical. This has a 40% crit chance. Yeah, this has a 40% crit chance. This has also 40. Let's throw this away. Let's go here. Nice. On crits, and this is on hits. I would say on hits, boomerang. And then boomerang on hit again. I don't have it on hit, actually. Periodically. So does this work? Yes, it does work. So while the boomerang is mid-flight, actually forget that. On crit, let's go with poison. Because why not? Why not also poison opponents? Although this does 30 damage and the poison does 14. Okay, let's keep the poison and let's go on. I think I really, really want to get brain capacity. let's sell some things, honestly. Let's sell this. What is this? Offspring of the Mutant. Generate mutants that last for the duration when active. Mutants cannot move or get damaged. Each organ allocates between this organ and brain and reduces fertility. What? Sell it. I don't care. Retina of the Raven, buy. Retina of the Raven, buy. Cockley of the Cat. I still don't know where to put that. Like, it's completely useless. Let's sell it. We have a higher version anyway. Let's sell the Lung of the Navel. Let's also maybe not sell this. How much money do we have? Boomerang Closer. 8 damage. This does 3 damage. Well, because of this having efficiency very low. Yeah, I see. I see how it is. Let's run this. Let us go. Okay, madness, of course. And whenever opponents get hit, there is also like a slam or hammer thing happening. Red wave 10. We are busted. Because this game is literally a busted game generator, man. This is by far the most busted. Yeah, it's just create busted builds the game. I don't think there is anything else to be explained here. Now, of course, there are unlockables. So whatever you see is not everything that there is in this game. After beating this, because I don't see us losing. So after beating this, we'll most likely unlock a bunch of things. I think you unlock a character by having 4 brains. So I will... Whoa, boss. Okay, a laser is incoming. And the boss is over there. I enjoy that they have like a square on it. Ho ho ho. Look at all our spikes going through the boss. Excuse me? Is the box gonna stay like this so small? Please don't tell me it's one of those it touches you, you die bosses. Because that's, in my opinion, one of the most bad mechanics in every game ever. I don't believe that the day is going to be touches you, you die. But you never know, man. You never know. We're gonna do big loops around it. And hopefully it's gonna go down today. Got it. Very nice. Now we can loop around here and try. Oh no, we lost some life. Who cares? I really enjoy that you have 4 life and then you fully heal every time you end the run. and the wave. That's really enjoyable and clean and simple. You don't have to really care about health and whatnot. Managing health is not a thing in this game. What did I get from the boss? The Lung of the Bullfrog. Atomize the effect of the right side organ makes it surround. Yeah, okay. It is what it is. Tentacle of the Hornet with double right side. Okay, I'm gonna take this. Yeah, straight up. Short range attack thing. I don't know why you would either take something that doesn't have a right side, unless there is any upside on that. Anyway, Tentacle of the Swordfish, Lung of the Puffer, atomize the effect once again, activate the right side organ. Let's take whatever, man. Tentacle of the Dragon, legendary version. Yeah, the self-surrounding projectiles. Offspring of the Imp, generate imps that last for long for duration when activated. Imps cannot move, but can be damaged by you. Each organ locates between this organ and brain function. Okay, the idea of this is that you poison or explode your imps, and then the imps, the imps activate a bunch of other effects. At least that's how I understand this. Where did we have this thing? I think it was somewhere. Yeah, where did we have that? I'm trying to find it. You know what? Let's go into culture. Let's go into brain capacity. Nice. Now we're super strong. And into the build we shall go. So on explosion, I guess. Oh, no. I ran out of spines and other things that can chain react. Well, at least I have these things going. So let's go here. These, once again, let's leave them for now. Oh, here it is. I found it. So let's put the better one in as this stays the same. And then over here, I can only put in a spine. There is no reason to put a spine in there. Over here, I can also only put in a spine plus something else. You know what? Let's go here. Although it's going to be... Oh, no. It actually activates. So let's put in this... I guess a boomerang. You know, after the starfish, a bunch of boomerang flies out. Over here, this is a boomerang. So I can either put something here or here. I'm going to put it here. This is the periodically activation. Which is, in my opinion, mediocre, but whatever. The boomerang is now periodically... Oh, I understand what's happening. So this has duration 3. And this has rate of 0.9 every second. So that's why it said sometimes isn't fast enough. Because some things just expire too fast for the other thing to fire. I now understand. And I can have one more. And that one more over here doesn't even make any sense. As there is nothing else. Can I try this for a moment? What can I put on the right side of this? This. Okay. That means the right side organ and makes it surround. What does that even mean? The only thing I understand here is that the boomerangs are going to have that effect going on. That's the only thing I can understand from that. Ooh, that is exactly what it does. Okay, now we have boomerangs with flames. So we keep that. I guess that's what it means. I don't see anything being able to connect anymore. So let's just continue. Culture. I'm going to say, first of all, let's sell some things. Retina, once again, is never gonna get used. I don't have offsprings. I don't have retina. Just nothing connects to retina. Yeah, nothing connects to retina. Nothing. Because if it would, then you would see greens like these, but there isn't. So let's sell this. Wait a minute. Do I have a right side activation? That's a double one. That's also a double one. Yeah, we don't have any of these. Oh, here we have one. So let's just upgrade it straight up. So this is once per second, 120. This is 0.97 per second, 150, just straight up more damage. Oh, not enough duration though. Well, guess we're gonna go with this, because this has 1 second duration. So at the end of this thing's duration, the boomerang's gonna fly out. That's how I understand this. And let's go culture. I'm gonna say let's go get another brain, so that we unlock the character. We have a new brain here, let's just invest anything into this. We're gonna go with activates every 0.97. Let's go with explosions. And here, I pretty much cannot put anything in. This thing is accepted by anything that accepts lungs. Do you accept lungs? No. And this accepts lungs, so we're going to go here. Then we're going to go here. And now we're going to go nothing. Because I don't have a wing, a belly, or a poison bag. Well, for now, we have Tentacle of the Dragon surrounding us. So there's that. Let's go. So I now understand some things. Yeah, what I understand is the atomization effect applies on it. Do you see? Oh, yeah, I need to take that flame and put it on the dragon I just got. Because that means that the things surrounding us are going to have the flame effect. That's what atomization means, I would assume. That the effect applies on the weapon itself. So right now, for example, I have applied on the boomerangs this flame circle effect. So theoretically, I could apply that same effect on the dragons that are surrounding us. So I'm going to try it next. Like the moment I go back to shop, I'm gonna try to transfer that flame thing that I put on the boomerangs on the dragons around us. Or actually on those dragons that are the big dragons that we have. You know, those huge dragons that just fly all over the place. Those things should have the atomization of fire on them. Hey, look, another retina. Still useless. Now, of course, everything that you're seeing here, after I play this game a lot of times, I should easily be, not easily be, but you slowly should understand what combos with what, right? Like, for example, the boomerangs can combo with the atomization effect that then can give them fire or poison or whatever stats effect you want to apply on them. And then you have to understand what the retina does or what the poison bags do or what the wings do, etc., etc., etc. Right now, of course, I am missing all that information as I'm playing the game for the first time, literally. I just played it for, 3 minutes just to read through the tutorial and then instantly into the run we shall go. Okay, we got three things, whatever. Spine of the chimpanzee. Activate the right side organ periodically every... very rarely, but efficiency 300. Well, we're gonna take that regardless because it's a rare. Belly of the broad crawl. Yeah, we're gonna take that. This is a belly, so we're gonna be able to apply it on something. And it also has a right side, so poison bag, I see it, but whatever. Let's go here. And now, we're gonna go over to the madness. This is the madness, right? Yeah, because the starfish hits, so madness happens. Atomize the wings. No, we're not gonna atomize the wings. We're gonna throw the wings away. We're gonna atomize the blade. Can I see this now? Theoretically, these huge things around us should have flames now. I guess they don't. Yeah, you see this? Like, they don't seem to have the flames. They don't seem to have the flame effect I was expecting them to have. So, we're back to not knowing what exactly is happening. If it hits a target, the dragon appears. Atomize the right side effect. Right side effect is the belly of the blood crawl. Wait a minute. What's the fire? Is this the fire? Blood crawl trauma. Yeah, that's the fire and this is the tentacle. So, I'm missing something here. Ah. It's okay. Let's try to get the wings on something, I guess. I can't really... Oh, I can put something here. No, that's useless. I can put a retina? No way. Activate the right side organ while host affected by the left side organ die. Okay. Let's see where I can put the wings, maybe. So that we get the buff going. I think I can get the wings from anywhere. Oh, here we go. Let's start maybe expanding. Let's actually go with the wings here. Let's go with the triple activation. Actually, this is a single activation. Yeah, if I do it like this, then from this thing, things are gonna be firing. That's what that means. So for example, explosions are gonna be firing, and also boomerangs, and also this thing, right? And then I can't really chain react, but let me show you what this is gonna look like. So we're gonna have some things around us that are gonna be firing things themselves. Or at least that's how I understand it. Which theoretically is good, but practically I would just prefer going with, triple here. And now on the right, yeah, I don't care about that right now. Let's go with starfish. And then some starfish. Yeah, duration not enough. We're gonna go with, what is this? 1 second duration. I need something that has a big duration. 1 second duration. 3 second duration. We're gonna go, that's not combinable. Yeah, whatever. Activate the boomerang once in a while. Activate the shot once in a while. And the shot, not enough duration. Yeah, this is very slow for it to be able to durate enough. A lot of mechanics in action here. Not enough duration, of course. Of course not. Well, let's go with how we had it. Wait a minute, where's my boomerang? I didn't have a boomerang, actually. I had... Wait, what? Where's my, where's this? Where's this? Okay, I don't know why this... I don't know why things just disappear altogether. We get the buff. It shoots out. It shoots out some hammer slammer. It shoots out some machine gunnery. It also shoots out some boomerangs. I don't care. And yeah, that's enough in my opinion. So let's go. Maybe I can also make them explode. Yeah, instead of doing that, let's make them explode. And then there's that. Can I see this? So theoretically, they should be going around us. And once in a while, explosion should be happening around us. Or at least that's the idea. Whatever. Let's go. Let's level up. 600 plus. Let's get quality, and damage. Pick up range. Drop rate. Let's go. Wave 12. We become better and better. Yeah, do you see that around us we have this thing going on? Yeah, it's actually happening. So, once in a while around us, random explosions and hammer slammers are happening. That's happening from the dragons themselves. Of course, as you can see, the less opponents we have, the worse our build is. Because we very much heavily rely on chain reaction effects. But the moment something comes into our vicinity, we just start flinging out fire boomerangs and, you know, pretty much everything else. I don't know what the fire effect actually is. I have completely lost the point where what exactly the fire effect was. There's this flame thing. I'm saying fire, but it might not be fire, right? I'm talking about what the boomerangs have. This circle that appears around them. I would like to be able to apply that effect on those thousands upon thousands of skulls that we have flying all over the place. That's what I tried to do at least. But I didn't find it. I'm gonna search it up a moment again. So I'm gonna look into all the boomerangs I have, and I'm gonna look at what the right side of them is. And I'm gonna try to take that right side as is and put it on the millions upon millions of surrounding skulls that we have. So we can maybe see what exactly is happening. Oh look, some starfish and some money and in our spine. Honestly, I think the best effect is the on-hit trigger thing. That seems to be have a big difference in power level. Spine of the chimpanzee, single one. Intestine, spread effects of right side going on the ground, whatever. Belly of the fire lizard, inflict blaze on target ration, let's take that. Nerve, activate the right side organ, left side crits. Ah, crits are easy to do. Take off a beetle, a boomerang with double thing, let's go with it. Okay, so let's look through all our boomerangs. This one doesn't do anything. There is no boomerang here. No, actually there is, this one. Which, this is definitely not the flame boomerang because there is no flame in this line. Next one is this boomerang here, which this has to be the flame, right? This has to be the flame boomerang. And then this is the new one. So this is the flame boomerang for sure. Let's take this part. Okay. And let's put it on this guy. So we're going to be like, we give him this. Atomizes the effect of the right side organ and makes it surround. Atomize the effect of the right side organ and makes it surround. What's the difference between those two wordings? Atomizes the. Atomizes the. Atomize. I guess let's try it. And then this was, I guess this one. Which is practically the same. Right? The difference being that this does 4 damage. Actually, no matter what I put in there, it's going to be 4 damage. Put this. Let's test for a moment. It's not going to work. Oh yeah, it now somehow works. So atomizes with atomize is a different thing. As you understand, we just became broken, right? So what is this though? You know what? I want to see that now in action too. So let's go over to our madness build and show me what this is. Belly of the lizard. I want to see what this looks like. Is this going to be maddening too? Oh, okay. It's the same thing, but with a different color. Nice. So what does that mean? What of these two is better? Which of these two is better? This inflict blaze on the target. Duration when activated, blaze can be stacked multiple times. Through each stack has its own duration. When the duration of a stack's ended, the effect by the blaze dies. All that consumed instantly. Okay. Trigger an explosion. This is trauma deals damage to the target each time it applies new trauma stacks. This damage based on trauma stacks already. Okay, let's try to see the difference here in this in the training. So this is we apply millions upon millions of flames. Oh, and they explode. Okay. And can I see this? Because honestly speaking, the trauma might be even more damage. Right? Because we just amass 6,000, 7,000 damage, 9,000 damage, 14,000, 15,000 damage. Okay, this is of course more. Right? This is obviously more damage. And not only like this isn't even remotely close to how much more damage this is. Let's double check. Is this even doing 10,000 damage? Even remotely close to 10,000 damage? Maybe the explosions are gonna do. Yeah, the explosions are doing thousands. Nope. This is we just found a completely busted and broken build. Which we might use and abuse for the rest of the game forever. Like Lung of the Bullfrog, alongside Dragon, alongside Bloodcrawl. Like this triple insanity is just busted. Let's make the boomerangs. What does it do if I do this? And then I do the flame here. Are the boomerangs going to be flaming? Are the boomerangs going to be burning opponents? Is that the idea? I'm waiting for an explosion to happen or something. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what atomize means, man. Atomize is the effect. No idea. Just straight up no idea. Well, regardless, let's go with triggers on crits. This has a 25% crit chance, which is on the lower end. How much crit chance does this have? This doesn't even have a crit chance. Oh, I can put this on here. Activates the right side organ while effects of the left side organ expire. This expires every 3 seconds. Right? While effects expire or when units die. Let's go when units die. Actually, expire and die should be the same thing anyway. I shoot out even more boomerangs. Need more capacity. We're gonna just get rid of this and this, as they don't even do anything, honestly. And I think we're good. 9 out of 10. This can be fixed here. Let's put like this on crit. 37% crit chance, 32. Yeah, let's go here on crit. And I'm gonna say on crit, let's burn opponents. That would make sense, at least in my opinion. And yeah, we got 4 brains, everything set up. 800 coins. I'm gonna say, let's go with a bunch of health. Why though? Let's go with movement speed, health. Actually, drop chance, drop chance, drop chance. Yeah, just a bunch of drop chance. So give me a second here too. I'm coming back. Okay, so I'm back. Off we go into the rest of the run. The madness run is gonna begin now, pretty much. So we're of course completely naturally broken, as far as we have seen. Now, only if I actually have this activation going on, but yeah, when the activation happens, everything around us is toast. Like super toast, more toast than toasty toast. but when the activation doesn't happen, I'm not that powerful. Although it's really easy to get the activations going, as most of the things we have is on hit. So we're just straight up busted. I think I'm gonna go with movement speed and pickup range next. Maybe I'm gonna start selling some organs, of course. Now that we got everything that we pretty much wanted, which is gathering. And look, we're doing nothing when... Oh, the stage is actually finite. Nice. Not every, game of these, of this, you know, I guess, thing. Not every game of this nature actually has a finite stage. Well, this one does, so that's very nice. We got like a sword or whatever. Let's continue going on. Just running through, coming through. Maybe find another on-hit effect or something. Just to create even more chain reactions. Hey, look, another sword thing. Nice, nice, nice. 500 plus coins. Yeah, I'm gonna go a bunch of movement speed and pickup range next. After I get a bunch of, you know, organ finding. Oh, look at all this. What is this? Wings of the Giant Bat. Grant increased organ damage for a duration when activated. The buff effect scales with efficiency of the left side organ. Okay. Does this spread the right side? Yeah, whatever. What is this? Belly of the Elk Chew. Inflict shock on the target for a duration when activated. Hosts affected by shock take increased damage from all sources. The debuff effect scales with efficiency of the right side organ. Okay. And then we got this thing. Effective radius 5.25. Yeah, I launched short time attack. Okay. Off end, retrieve unpicked. Once for 30. Spine of the chimpanzee, once again, activate things. Quasar repeated activation, let's take that. Tentacles. Yeah. Yeah, what's the difference between these two, by the way? This has 1% more crit chance. Physical speed. Yeah, and it also moves a bit faster. Okay, otherwise, same compatibility, same everything. Yeah, wait, this is just straight up better, right? Why would I take this any time of the day? We're gonna take this, though, for selling it, maybe. Offspring of the Imp. Generate imps that last for a duration when activated. Imps cannot move, but can be damaged by you. You know what? I could theoretically take this. I have an idea. Let's take this. So, oh, I don't have what I need for the idea. There is... Isn't this thing activate the right side of the ground when damage taken? Yeah, exactly. That's what I wanted. That's part of the idea. So I think I'm gonna destroy one of these chain reactions. First of all, this is gonna definitely stay. I think this is the worst one. Yeah, I think this doesn't really do that much. So let's disconnect everything here. And I'm gonna say, first of all, we're gonna activate the right side every time. Let's go with activate a bunch of things. What is this? You know what? Let's go with activate a bunch of things. Here I'm gonna say let's get an imp, generate imps that last for a duration that I can attack. And then when the imps get hit, you see, activate the right side when damage taken from the imp. Some organs weakened once they are distant from the rain. Yeah, okay. So, not enough fertility. What does that even mean? Joins the glorious evolution. Can I have this earlier? Can I put like a better thing in here? Can I maybe fix this? Organ and brain, you reduce fertility by 20%. Fertility 0.68, decay 20%. Yeah, but it doesn't explain to me what exactly that even means. Still, it's the same. Well, let's just put the best chimpanzee in there. Which is this one, I think. Yeah, this one. Okay, so when that gets hit, it activates, I guess, the machine gun. Ah, the spine. Actually, the dragon. And then the dragon atomizes lung of the puffer, lung of the narwhal. Not sure, once again, I'm not really sure about the differences here. On the right side organ crits, so 3% crit chance. Actually, no, let's go with the atomize. Can I for a moment go back to the madness thing here? This is lung of the bullfrog, so the bullfrog thing seems to be the one that we actually want. So the bullfrog puffer, yeah, that's different again, narwhal. Let's try this, try burn, try buff. Okay, and then we're gonna go with, when the burn happens, spread the off the right side, working on the ground, let's go like this, into shock. I don't even know what we're doing, man. Let's go test this. So theoretically, I'm spawning an imp every once in a while that I can hit, right? Or is the spawn the thing not happening because of the lack of whatever? Yeah, I think the spawn is not happening because I'm lacking the thing that it said I'm lacking. Yeah, the imp is not just straight up not spawning. Yeah, but how do I make the spawn? By the way, let's go back to the tutorial for a moment. Organ decay. Some organs are weakened once they are distant from the brain. Notice the decay hit on the info panel. Yeah, but that thing is literally next to the brain. Not enough fertility, it says. Duration 11 seconds, fertility 0.76. So it just never spawns. Is that what I get here? Can I make it somehow spawn? Oh, now it doesn't say not enough fertility anymore. Yeah, I needed a lot of efficiency for that to happen, I guess. Okay, so does it work now? Stay away. Here it is. Oh, it does its thing. Like, it attacks. And now when I'm attacking it, it allows me to trigger a bunch of things. So that's pretty much the idea of the imp here. That we have something that allows us to trigger all my abilities. Nice, I love it. Let's go. Let's go with finding a bunch of organs. And let's go with, like, damage. Battle. So now I have something that I can, you know, hit. So I trigger all my triggers. That's the idea here. That I have my own little sponge. That whenever I hit it, I activate what I want. And when the sponge itself gets hit, it activates this star-shaped thing. And it also has the things around it, as you can see, right? It's spawning the things that move in loops. Nice. I guess the skeleton heads. I don't know what to call them. Hey, look, it's another bullfrog thing. I hope it's this good one. The one that allows me to chain reactive effects into each other. Which, if that is the case, I'm gonna put it on the imp that we just got. So nice. Oh, look how many organs we're getting, man. This is just crazy. And we're busted. And this video seems to be an hour long, which I was not intending to do. But it is what it is. First time playing. Trying to play around. I hope you guys enjoy this. I hope you guys really enjoy. If you do, drop a like to the channel. Like, I hope you guys enjoy the experimenting and trying to min-max. To see what you can do in this game. Now, of course, if I continue playing this, I will very quickly start. I mean, very quickly. I'm a bit overreacting here, but I should theoretically slowly start realizing what works with what a good combo is, what the best things are, etc., etc., etc. But in my opinion, we achieved a completely busted, broken build right away. Right? As you can see, nothing really can even remotely survive. It's not like we're a one shot on everything, but after opponents get a couple of stacks of poison, they're toast. And we got our puffer. And we got our bullfrog. The bullfrog, of course, is busted. Belly of the short run. Affects wither on the target duration when activated. Targets affected die instantly while their HP falls below a certain threshold. The debuff affects skills with efficiency on of the left side organ. Okay. Boxer once again. Puffer. Mutant. Generates mutants that last for a duration when activated. Mutants cannot move or get damaged. Each organ locates between this organ and brain reduces. No. A very quick vessel though. 1.2 second activation time. On hit, activate, yes. with your mutation. Let's go get this pet going. So on hit, shoots out these thingies. I'm gonna say, I'm gonna put here this thing. It's already here, right? This is already buffer, so let's just do this. And then here we're gonna say this. Not buffer, where's the bullfrog? Where's the bullfrog? Here it is. So we're gonna put a bullfrog here, so now this flame is gonna just flame around. And I still don't know what this is, but it doesn't matter. I'm not even sure if it matters. Retina. Activate the right side organ, will host effect, but left side will die. Okay, this is actually good. So let's put an organ here, and then let's activate... I would say starfish. Just machine gunnery. Or this. Actual machine gunnery. And let's start selling things. Because there is no reason to have all of that. All of these. Is this better or this? Nope, the one I have is better. Let's like sell this and this and this. This and this. And this. And these. And a boomerang and a retina. And like a machine gun. And like the puffer thingies, which I don't even know what they do. Like a couple of these. I'm not even looking what I'm deleting. Poison opponents. Grass and organ damage effect during an activation. You know what? Let's just put this here. Nice. Can I see this moment? So theoretically, when we summon now something, it's gonna be even more madness overall. Yeah. Yeah. Now they also have their own thing that flies around. Okay, I love it. We're completely busted. Another brain? Imagine. Another brain capacity though. No. Let's go with... You know what? Let's go with... Cells you pick up have a 10% chance to duplicate. Ah, money gathering. I see. Well, let's go with crits and crits. Let's go with damage, damage, damage. I think we're good to go. Pick up range once. Let's go. Maybe movement speed and HP was the play. I think this is the last wave. So maybe let's just sell everything. And just get our upgrades going. Might be wrong about what I'm doing here, but I don't think so. I'm gonna try my best. Let's maybe spam HP. Is the HP fixed? No, it's not. Dang it! That was a mistake. It is what it is. Let's go with everything we want. Warning, warning, boss. Well, the boss gonna die almost instantly. The boss is actually gonna die almost instantly, just so you guys know. And the boss is dead. Yep, the boss is dead. Come on, what? Are you serious right now? Okay, thank you very much. The reason why I said the boss is almost instantly dead is because I was doing 5,000 damage to it. Like 7 and 9,000 damage. Our DPS is just through the roof. I mean, look at this. Look, do you realize that I think the one imp hits the other imp? Therefore, even if I'm not there, they're still gonna chain react into each other. I mean, look at this. We're just doing circular patterns of flame, poison, and everything else. And whatever burns to the ground, let's not forget, it also explodes on death. So just madness all over the place. This whole idea of torment is extremely powerful. Like, I think we found a very, very, very busted thing here that we're gonna be using and abusing for the rest of this game's life, pretty much, if I continue playing this. That is the lungs of the bullfrog, alongside the dragon head, alongside the flame, this belly of the beast, or whatever it's called. This effect of applying torment to the others. I mean, look at this. I can just sit here and nothing is gonna ever be able to do anything to us. Straight up. This is just straight up madness. I mean, look here in the middle. This is madness city. I just run towards opponents that would be taking 5,000 and 6,000 damage per hit. Which is just straight up crazy. And we got another heart right there. Very nice. Let's go see what we're gonna unlock. By the way, don't forget to drop a like, guys, before you leave. And subscribe if you wanna see more. Once again, I'm sorry, I'm sick. Can't really do anything about this. Trying my best here. I might be a bit under the weather, you know, as of livelihood, you know, being lively or whatever. But yeah, we're still breaking the game. We're still doing what we're supposed to do. So at this point, we have obviously won victory and we got light show and everything. Press any key to continue. Organ, bladder. We unlock the bladder. Root, okay. Genius, that's a character. Prolife Squander, character, Green Gland, new one, Harmony, new character, stage 2 of course, and let's see what the new characters look like. Protearth and Special, that's what we had. Genius, Protearth, amazing, operational ability, but its stamina is weak. So, the organ next to your brain has a 50% efficiency, can have up to eight sets of brains, but brain capacity is 4. Okay, so you just have a bunch of brains with the first organ doing a bunch of damage, but you will not be able to get a bunch of chain reactions, which is theoretically bad. Like, chain reactions were the carry, were the most powerful part of this. By the way, I just realized there is speed over here, 450, 500. Okay. The following is in the luck link, 3 different offsprings. Okay. Prototype whose power grows with variety of linked organs. Every unique organ link grants 5% increased organ efficiency. Yeah, that's good. That's definitely better than the one we had. Your brain is disabled unless the amount of unique organ types exceed the amount of your brain types. That's... Wait, your brain is disabled unless the amount of unique organ types exceeds the amount of your brain sets. Okay, so if you have 4 brains, you're supposed to have at least 5 different organs in each one of them. Very easy to achieve. So this guy's actually really strong as far as I understand, but it's just restricting you a bit. How many characters are there? Beat with queen, beat with sheep, beat with wave without killing any monster. Okay. That should be easy. A prototype which consumes cells efficiency. You lose all cells at the start of waves. The culture root costs 20% less cells. Oh, nice. This is like the entrepreneur from Brotato. So you, everything is cheaper, but you lose the money at the end. That's bad-ish, but okay. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. As I said, drop a like to the channel. Thanks for the Patreon members and supporters, as always. And yeah, hopefully in a couple of days, I'm going to be better. And I'm going to be able to have my normal voice back. So yeah, I hope you guys really enjoyed. This was such an awesome game. I'm going to continue playing this. This is just insanely awesome as a game. I do enjoy this a lot. I hope you guys enjoyed, actually, because if you don't, I don't think I'm going to continue playing this. But I did. So if you also do, then together, I'm going to continue playing this game. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. Once again, thanks for watching, and see you guys around.